Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler, and helping me call this one is Kirk Herbstreit. And Aaron Andrews also joins us on the sidelines. Welcome to today's game, brought to you by EA Sports and ESPN. Our matchup is between the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets and the LSU Tigers. In the state capital of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, the fans at Tiger Stadium are fired up for this intense matchup. For the Tigers, what should we be looking for from them today?
They bring everything to the table. They can run or they can pass, and they use a lot of different skill position players. It's not the flashiest offense around, but when it's working, it's one of the most effective.
For LSU, they like to move the ball downfield behind their top-notch receiver.
Question is, will he be able to get open against a fantastic cover corner? We'll really want to keep an eye on this matchup.
Now we head to midfield for the coin toss and remind you that today's game is brought to you by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, the perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Taken from the 10. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Nice run there as they work the outside. 6-yard pickup. Second and four.
They faced a blitz by both inside linebackers on that play and were still able to move the chains through the air. Nice play.
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down.
The defense brought pressure up front and totally overwhelmed the offensive line. That one was doomed from the start.
Caught, and he's in immediately. They got a little bit there, but less than a yard.
It was a nice catch by the sophomore, but it was well played by the defense to stop him for a minimal gain.
Back to pass.
Pretty much the best way to make sure the receiver doesn't catch it. He just put his pads on him the second he touched it.
Fourth down. Looks like they're going to punt it away here. And he's tackled at the 20-yard line.
Well, the coverage team did their job and made the play. Let's see if the defense can continue the effort.
About the 23-yard line. The option to the fullback gets about three.
That'll make it second to seven.
Option here. They bring him down in the backfield.
When this guy gets his arms around the ball carrier, I don't care who it is. He's not getting away.
It's third down and 7 yards to go.
Ball on their own 23.
I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem. to pass. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
Fourth down. The punt team is on the field looking to kick this one away. Tackle at the 49-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
This quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Run the middle and nothing there. A 1 yard gain on the play.
And the defense had great pressure there. They blitzed the middle linebacker and there were no holes for the halfback to run through.
There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Score that round for the defense. These guys are flying around right now. Outstanding pressure here on the quarterback. They sent every one of those linebackers, and even though they couldn't get to the quarterback, they were able to prevent the first down.
And he just got stood up right there. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. Looks like an option here. Makes it out to about the 29. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. They'll option left. Tackle made at the 28.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
They'll run the option. The defense was that close to coming up with a big play.
Yeah, they tried to get a little bit too fancy there on that option play.
It's getting louder down in the field. Looks for his running back incomplete. The quarterback had a tough time with a blitz on that one.
Now with this guy, you can't let him stand back there and have too much time to throw the ball. You've got to get a hand in his face.
And down he goes at the 36-yard line. The last time this offense had the ball, it was three and out. Gives it to the back. Tackle at the 44. A nice job on the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8.
That brings up second and 1.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Pressure from the defense. They brought the heat. Wasn't much room for the running back to work with.
They're going to pitch it. He's taken down the 48-yard line. 3 yards there for the halfback, and that'll move the chains.
Another good run from this running back. Let's see if he continues to get his carries as they continue with this drive.
From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. Takes the handoff inside and stopped immediately.
He knew it was a run all the way. Got a good jump. Once he got there, He wasn't about to let him slip away either.
And we're all tied up at the end of the first quarter.
At the end of the first quarter, the score is tight.
From their own 48-yard line, second down. He'll get it again. Tackled after a decent pickup. They'll get 6 yards. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Back to pass. The ball is loose. And the defense picks it up. Gets some open field. To the 20. Touchdown. Huge play. That was a great play by the defense, and now they have the momentum.
Things are going their way right now, and they'll be right back on the defensive side of the ball trying to make a quick stop so they can get the ball right back.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Georgia Tech, the kick. Taken from the 10. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. It was a rough road on their last drive as the fumble led to a touchdown.
I know as a quarterback, it's always hard to watch the defense score a touchdown on it. But it was always a reminder to take extra care of the football.
Taken down in the backfield.
Got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 24-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. And he's tackled at the 41.
Really a nicely thrown ball and a good job by the receiver to run right under.
It's first and 10. Hit out of bounds at about the 49.
That was spectacular. He skied for that pass and somehow got his hands on it and made the catch.
From their own 49-yard line, it's second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Pulls down the catch and he's got room here.
That's the beauty of running play action against zone coverage. And man, the defender has his eyes on the guy's cover. But in zone, the defender's looking right at the quarterback. That's why that play action worked so well for a first down. They weren't sure if it was a run or a pass.
First and 10, ball on the 39. Try the option, left side. Nice run there as they work the outside. He decides to keep it and picks up 7 yards.
Second and 3.
And he's tackled after passing yardage.
They've obviously found the formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
First and 10. Ball on the 28. He'll get it again. Runs it left for a decent game. And a pickup of about 7. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Second down.
And it's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
It's the ninth play of the drive. It's first down. Expect the defense to turn it up a notch here in the red zone. He drops back. And he can't get away from the pressure.
It was his indecision that led to that sack. He had time to throw, but never pulled the trigger. And eventually, the pocket just caved in.
Second down and 12. And this is the 10th play of the drive. They go with the back, and he's hammered in the backfield.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
Looks to pass. Looks like someone was called for holding.
Holding on the offense.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
From the 33-yard line, it's third down. He drops back. They bring the quarterback down.
You can credit some of that to the blitz. The offensive line just wasn't able to handle all the pressure on that play.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. A four-point lead. It was the umpire that threw the flag, and generally, that's a holding penalty.
Holding on the offense.
Well, if you want to ruin a drive, just grab a hold of a defender's jersey.
So the penalty puts him back for a first and long. Georgia Tech is up by four. Here's the option to the right. A yard, if that, on the quarterback keeper. Second and long, ball on the 19-yard line. Here's the option. And now the ball is loose. A great first half comes to a close. Our score here in Baton Rouge, Georgia Tech 7, LSU 3. are set to start the second half. Both teams are on the field, and we're ready to go. Gathered in at the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Let's see how the offense rebounds after fumbling on their last possession.
The defense, I'm sure, will be aggressive again. They love going for the strip and attacking the football.
They'll run the option. He laterals the ball. He takes it right side for a good gain. So he picks up about 5 on the option to the halfback.
That brings up 2nd and 5.
Georgia Tech is up 4. Here's the option to the right. He's knocked out of bounds around the 30-yard line. So the tailback gets 2 yards on the option.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
They go with the option. Nice gain as he works to the right side.
Strong play by the defense, but they'll come up just shy of the stop.
First and 10. Ball on their own 35. Takes a handoff inside and stopped immediately. The fullback back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's it.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
Looks like an option here. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
It's broken up.
Smart play, being ready for the pass and swatting it away.
It's 4th down. Looks like they're going to punt it away here. Tackle made at the 33. And that was excellent punt coverage.
I agree, Brad. That was very well defended.
Somehow gets the ball away. And he got it to the sophomore. So on 1st down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked the perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
First and 10, ball on the 35-yard line. It to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. So a nice little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a 1st down.
That was a very good-looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 18-yard line. They're in the red zone again, but this time they should be thinking touchdown. Works the right side. They get 5 yards on the play. From the 13-yard line, it's 2nd down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. And a nice run by the tailback.
Not a lot of razzle-dazzle here, but it gets the job done and picks up the 1st down.
Let's see if they can put it in from 6 yards out. He drops back. Throws it, and oh, he dropped it.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
And we have an update on an injury. Aaron?
Thanks, Brad. When the injury first occurred, the trainers believed he had broken a rib. However, they have since downgraded that to only a bruise. He's been cleared to return to the game. Brad, back to you.
Sounds like good news then. Thanks, Aaron. They're crowding the line. They go with the toss. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
I like the combination of speed and strength that this cornerback plays with. He's a real valuable part of the defense.
And it sails right on him. No good. And they come away empty-handed.
The kicker just cannot hang his head after that miss. I know he should have made it, but they may need him a little bit later on. And he needs to be ready and confident when that happens.
They'll get the ball here at the 20. It's first and 10.
About receivers coming over the middle taking shots from the safety, but a runner who's still in the backfield, this guy just flies all over the field.
From their own 17-yard line, it's second down. Here's the option. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. A nice 7-yard gain on the option keeper.
That'll bring up 36.
That's exactly how they drew it up on the sideline, and now they get the ball back.
Fourth down.
So it's fourth down. They come out in a punt formation. Out to about the 45-yard line. The kicker missed a field goal on the last drive, so the offense is out here trying to turn it around on this one.
Anytime you have a shot at putting points on the board and you don't get it, you get a little frustrated. But this offense is very capable of scoring at any time.
They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Makes it to the 44.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
First and 10, ball on the 44-yard line. Straight in the middle, and he meets the defense. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
And that's the safety who stepped up to make that tackle.
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. Open man, and it's his wide receiver.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you'd like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
First and 10, ball on the 29-yard line. Tackle in the backfield for a loss. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what, that was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. Our score here in Death Valley, Georgia Tech 7, LSU 3. Second and long. Sweep left. And they'll get him in the backfield.
Score that one is a win for the defensive line. They got the better of the offensive line right there.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 19. Gives it to the back.
trailing, time's a factor. Why not make your offense more of a vertical threat instead of running?
It's up.
That's big because now a field goal doesn't do a whole lot of good. There's still a touchdown behind.
So it's make or break time. Who's going to rise to the challenge? They're on the option, and they got him for a loss. The quarterback tried to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. Throws out to the running back, no good.
Boy, that was a lot. If the receiver didn't come down with it, the quarterback made sure nobody else was going to come down with it either.
From their own 30-yard line, third down. They can't hear a thing down there. Back to pass. Looking for his man. Incomplete. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time. But he'll get the next one.
Tackled at the 32.
You hope that a lane or two will open up and give you some space to work with, but that never happened on this kick.
This drive will start at the 32-yard line. First down, 10 to go. He looks to throw on first down. Throws out to the back, and it's through his hands.
Number 34, the intended receiver.
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 32. Takes it left on the option.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
They necessarily have to go for it here on fourth down. There's no doubt, time is becoming a factor.
That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. It was a quick three and out on their last possession. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 42.
Yards.
Back to pass.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
The pitch out, and he's got a block around the corner, and they make the stop at the 33. And the halfback toss gets maybe 3 yards. Here. He'll take it himself. And down he goes at the 14-yard line. The defense might have just run out of chances with that first down right there.
This offensive line definitely left it all on the field today.
From the 14-yard line, first down. The first time today, we'll get to see how this defense responds when they're backed up into the red zone. Straight in the middle, he meets the defense. The fullback back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's it.
That makes it second and 10.
Straight ahead with the fullback. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. They got 4 yards on that one. They've been 2 for 2 on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, Georgia Tech 7, LSU 3. Time to bring you the Reese's Perfect Play of the Game, which is brought to you by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, the perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter. Any final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
Coming into this game, it was a toss-up. Both teams could have been predicted to win, and no one would have blinked an eye. So the fact that it came down to the wire wasn't necessarily a surprise. LSU played a good game out there, but they needed to make one or two more big plays, and they couldn't do it. Who knows? Another couple of minutes, and this one may have gone the other way.
And for winning today's Player of the Game, EA Sports will make a $10,000 donation in his name to the school's General Scholarship Fund. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 11. Thanks for being with us. For my partners Kirk Herbstreit and Aaron Andrews and EA Sports, Brad Nessler saying goodbye.